face as a fish keeper who actually grow his or her fish, wearing it, you're practically going to be cleaning up a fish, and voila, there are eggs within the system. So what do you do? Well, I'm going to experiment. I'm going to try and see if I can hatch these fish, hatch these eggs. You can see it's a female, right? And this distinct thing with the female is that female tilapia is right here with the set. Alright, a bit too small for you to see, and place is a little dark. However, it is interesting to see how this entire episode turned out. So this is probably a two-clip video. A video very niche. I am gonna actually have to come back again to see what happened. Stop. From tilapia eggs to swimming fries to fingerlings. Hi everybody, welcome again to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. Okay, so I got a few of the larger tilapia out of this pond, right? Roughly about four. They are small, yes, as you can see. Normally, I would actually catch about one, measuring roughly between 7 to 8 inches in length, right? And weighing probably about 1 pound, somewhere near that, right? Okay, so what this video is all about. So I caught a tilapia from this pond, and I actually was cleaning it up inside. And after cleaning it up, well, when I started, you know, I normally place it into some water and let it stay in the water for a little bit. I did not put the ice, I did not use the ice methodology. I actually just let it stay and flatter a little bit, right? And after, you know, scaling one and cleaning up one, I went to the second one and I found these guys. One of the fish that I had was a female having eggs, right? Well, it had eggs in its mouth. The fact that it had eggs in its mouth, it suggests that the eggs have already been fertilized. Fertilization process have taken place. So therefore, the eggs in the mouth is just an incubation phase for the tilapia fries, right? But it was not yet time to release these fries into the water space. In looking at the fry, really in looking at the eggs, I realized that there was a distinct tail for most of the eggs. But you know, the eggs were not really moving that much. So I decided to actually look at the process as to see how this thing works. So it was a Sunday, so I placed it into an aquarium in which so happened to be empty. It wasn't all that clean, but I tried my luck. I placed the eggs into the aquarium, and after placing the eggs into the aquarium, after the first night, well, I placed it in the probably about 10 o'clock Sunday, right? And the next morning, well, the next evening, at about probably about 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock p.m., I saw these guys. I saw the eggs actually becoming what you call jumping beans, right? And this is what would actually happen within the mouth of the tilapia female, right? Where in which the eggs would be like jumping beans, but it will be much, it will be packed so much that they won't have that free space to jump, right? Now after about another day, another about 24 hours, I realized that they become a little bit more, I call it now, free jumping, right? Before it was like a little bit, you know, like from here to there, but now it's from here to there, right? After about 3 days, right, from actually getting the fish, taking the eggs out of the mouth, placing it in the aquarium, watching the beans jump, right, watching the eggs jump, right, to the, you know, it becoming free swimming, it took roughly between 3 to 4 days. Now after about 3 to 4 days, I saw this guys, the eggs actually became fries, and I have roughly 2 dozen tilapia fries in an aquarium inside. In addition to that, I have about 400 in a tote outside, right? In addition to that, I have another 15-20 dozen in two separate containers outside. So in total I have roughly about 600 tilapia full fish fries in my system. Now I am becoming overburdened with tilapia fries. It's a lot, guys. And I have some fingerlings, right? So in an effort to stave off the whole idea of my pond becoming, I call it now, choked, right, I have employed a new strategy wherein I have actually placed some of my fingerlings alongside the adults. Now the adults, as you would have actually discovered in one of my videos, I think it's the one about ingredients, the adults will not consume the young ones, right? It's the young ones which will consume the young ones. Now a point of correction here: the adults will not willfully go at the young ones to consume them, right? However, in certain circumstances they will consume the fingerlings, whereas if they are not being fed, if they are hungry, or they are just in their way, they will consume them, but they won't go out their way to actually leave it them and to consume them. As far as the fingerlings are concerned, the fingerlings will actually await the adults to release the fry, and then they will actually snap up the fries very quickly. And I think as a result of their like for live food, they actually grow very fast, right? So in an effort to stave off the whole idea of this whole system flooding with a lot of fries, I have actually placed some fingerlings in it. And any of these adult females who actually releases any babies between now and the next probably 3 or 4 weeks, I will not be taking them out. I will allow the fingerlings to actually consume them. And you might ask me why. I've shared that a while ago with you, that I've been overrun with tilapia fries, right? Now, it is hope that you have actually grasped something from this video. Remember to share, like, subscribe. Have a wonderful day, guys. Peace out. Catch you next time. Bye-bye.